Hi, Valiko is here again with another video. So in this one, I want to share how I recently got lucky when I managed to record something that I've never seen done before, namely the rapid evolution of a SpaceX Starlink satellite launch for four consecutive nights, starting just 12 hours after launch. It was amazing to see the train of 60 satellites spread out into a string of pearls, which caused some UFO sightings, and my observations even reached the media. It was actually good to see that the media search for proper explanations rather than just go for the usual, more sensational, so-called eyewitness reports from people misinterpreting what they saw while having no idea what it actually was. Those of you following my channel would have noticed that it's been about a year since I last added any more Starlink videos. Part of the reason is that back in the bad old days, astronomically speaking, Starlinks were quite spectacular when they were still very bright and easy to see, even weeks after launch. I remember how chuffed I was when I managed to catch a proper string of pearls just 5 days after launch. Due to pressure from the astronomical community, SpaceX started implementing several mitigation strategies to reduce their brightness dramatically, which now make them much more difficult to see or to photograph. Now they are almost only visible shortly after launch, while they're still in their initial low orbit or bunched together closely. Because they are launched in a variety of orbits, favorable flyovers have become fewer and fewer, hence the drought of Starlink videos here. Cloud and too bright conditions close to sunset or sunrise further reduce my opportunities. Occasionally one gets lucky with a surprise pass, but because this one was not followed up on subsequent nights, did not really warrant to make a video about it. Then on the 4th of February 2021, SpaceX launched their 18th batch of 60 Starlink satellites, which caused our little WhatsApp group to spring to life. As always, such a launch is very exciting to watch. Something I always watch out for is at what height the Starlinks are released, and it was quite exciting to see 275 kilometers, which is quite low compared to the usual 290 odd kilometers, meaning that they should be quite bright. But best of all was that heavensabove.com predicted visible passes for four consecutive nights for my location. Being relatively late meant that it would be dark, but unfortunately did not get very high in the sky, so I had mixed feelings if this would be good, but was hoping for the best. Since the first pass was barely 12 hours after launch, as expected, the 60 satellites were still very close together. My camera picked them up well before becoming visible to the naked eye, and the glittering precession brightened up nicely twice before disappearing in Earth's shadow. This gave me hope for the second night, where the pass was predicted to go slightly higher, the satellites would be further apart, and where the prospects looked good. I had to move my observing position to the left, but was surprised by how much, hence the pass being on the edge of the field. This time they really put on a terrific show. One could see the train grow in size as it got closer, before disappearing into Earth's shadow. Since favorable weather was expected elsewhere, our WhatsApp group sprang to life with observations from Brackenfell, Franschkraal and the Calais. This UFO was accidentally seen by many people all over South Africa, and as my explanatory video on Facebook was discovered, it was widely shared, hopefully making for an IFO. By now my hopes were up for the third night as the good weather continued. Because of the tree obscuring my view from my backyard, I had to move my observing location, which unfortunately meant a bright insecurity light in the frame, which did not help much to be able to see the satellites, which were very faint by now. As can be seen, the train since spread out substantially. I was somewhat disappointed by the pass, but it actually shows that SpaceX's mitigation measures are working. I did not have too much hope for the fourth and last night of our visibility spell, since it was predicted to stay low, meaning we will see it through lots of atmosphere. But fortunately, my fears were warranted. The only thing I saw while recording was a brief bright satellite, possibly the second rocket stage from the launch. Nothing was seen by eye. I doubled the exposure time and still barely managed to record the pass. Try watching this full screen, but I suspect YouTube's compression will kill the very subtle signs of Starlinks. They are barely visible above the camera noise, the result of running at high gain. The arrow points to where they were. Johan Leroux finally had clear weather at the Kelders and posted this image on our WhatsApp group, where he stacked all his DSLR pictures together. This gave me an idea to also stack my video frames using a fantastic freeware program called StarStacks, which you can see in action here. See how the image stacking helps to make the satellites visible. Johan then did the same with his frames. I also tried stacking with Rotten Stack, which eliminates the star trailing, to give me this. And so did Johan. All in all, a very rewarding exercise, which I have not seen anyone recording such a series of successive Starlink passes before.